Afternoon. Now, next meeting, I will still meet you so that I can entertain your questions, no? Maybe our last meeting will be on Wednesday. Okay? I can entertain your questions regarding the project in your. So, take note, no? May 31 is the deadline of the final project. Okay. So last meeting, we discussed this. What did we have last meeting? Roles demo, no? Let me open that, ano. So we already have a role demo, which means we can now add, delete. Okay. Wait, ang bagal, no? Let me open that again. Sinong dumating? Kindly chat me, no? So I'll not have a hard time looking for your name. Sigira. Sigira just came in. Okay. Anybody else? Wala na muna, no? Bueno, I've already checked the attendance. So what did we have? We already have role management and we have created CRUDs for the employees, no? I have a slight correction, no? Because by default, the edit will have an error. Okay. May error dito sa edit. For example, if you log in as an ordinary user, okay, and then you go to employee management, okay, you edit, you're not supposed to edit. Pag back mo dito, mag-error yon. Why is that? Because in your ano, in your role controller, the default, no, if you look at the role controller, or rather the employees controller, the default return for edit is return view. Okay? Di follow? Sinong dumating? Lioren? Anda Malerio? So there's a slight error in the code that was generated by Visual Studio. Now, sa edit yon, it works well, no? But if you have an access denied prompt, no? Kasi ito yung edit nyo. Okay. That's the delete. Where's the edit? Let me look for the edit, no? So delete index. Edit. Okay. This is the post. Yeah, may error ito, no? Especially the post part, no? Ito yung HTTP GET part, no? The post part. Ito dapat redirect to action, okay? I'll show you that later, no? Basta ito dapat ito return redirect to action, okay? You just copy this. Ipakita ko yung error, no? Because it will is if you have a denied prompt, you will have an error later. We'll show you that later anyway, no? Any questions? Manalo, you just came in. Long time no see. Okay. So anyway, dapat ito redirect to action, okay? You follow? So what do we have here? So if you look at this, our roles our employees controller, we have created the create role. The create is limited to administrator and secretary, no? The index is given to all, no? But the edit, okay? The edit is given to the administrator, and the delete is the administrator only. And the edit and the create is for the both the administrator and the secretary, no? Let's look at that. It's a matter of the index is given to all, no? And details is also given to all. Okay, so create is administrator and secretary, and then the edit is administrator and secretary. Okay, and the delete is for the administrator only. Do you follow? Okay, so for example, let's run this. So madali lang siya, no? It's not difficult. Although a lot of the codes are hidden and sometimes there are erroneous lines, you just have to tweak them a little bit. Okay? So let me log out and log in as secretary. S. So if I go to employee management, no? I can create new. Let me say, Mamaril Omulet. Reason. Okay. So, nandito na siya. Do you follow? Okay. But if the secretary, this is S, no? So, secretary, pag mag-click siya ng delete, that's access denied. Now, if you log out and then log in as an ordinary user, si R is an ordinary user, yeah. Okay, R is an ordinary user, and you go to the employee management. If you click edit, yeah. So ito yun, no? Pag mag-back ka, it should go back to this without the redirect. Okay, you will have an error. Walzak. Okay, you will have an error. Any questions so far? Okay. Now, wala pa tayong list. Wala tayong search. Do you follow? Okay. Wala tayong search. What I'd like to do is place the search here. No, ilagay ko dito ang search. Do you follow? So what I'd like to do is transfer the create button here. Okay. So how do we go about that? Let's look at the index of the employees, no? Ito. Okay, itong create, it's on the top, no? I'll transfer it to the control X, no? I'll transfer it to the header of the last column. Okay, ito yung blanco itong header na to, no? Okay, ililipat ko dito. Okay? And then you can add a class. You know Bootstrap, right? So you can say class equals btn, and then another class which is btn dash primary. Okay, lilipat natin dyan, and then we'll remove the paragraph here. It's not needed anymore. Okay, you follow? So ganyan, no? Okay. So ito, mag-create nyo na. You can add classes here, no? If you like. So it looks better. So let's do that first, no? So for example, the edit button, we'd like to add a class equal to btn and btn success. Okay? And then the details, we'll have a class, no? Class equals to BTN. You can look up at the Bootstrap site, no? BTN and BTN secondary. Okay. And then the delete, usually we would like it in red, so we'll have class equals BTN and BTN danger. So, nandito ito lahat sa Bootstrap site, no? You just search for Bootstrap button. Okay? So, what I'd like to do is to add a search form. Okay? So, ito. So, nandito na si create, nandito na yung delete, no? Okay? If you do an edit, that's access denied. Why is that? R kasi, no? If you delete, that's also access denied, no? You follow? The details is allowed. Edit, that's access denied, no? You follow? So, yung return.redirect is useful kasi kung mali, there will be an error. Okay? Any questions? What I'd like to have is put a search button here. No? Katulad ng ginawa natin sa ASP.NET. Okay? Let's close that. Let's look at the index.html. Dito sa header, gusto ko ilalagay yung ano. Okay? Dito ko ilalagay yung what? Yung search. Okay? Okay? How do you go about that? Okay. So, ang unang gagawin natin, we'll put this h1 into a div. Okay. So, nagagawa tayo ng table. To do a table, we should have a row and a column. So, we'll say div. Okay. Class equals row. Okay. Put it here. And then, ito gawin natin. Let's not do that. Let's not make it a column first. No? What we'll have is a form. Okay? We'll have a form. Let me copy this form na lang. No? Okay? A form which will search for the name of an employee. We'll just run this anyway. No? Last name of the employee. Okay? So, ito yung form. Wala muna tayong employee results, okay? Wala muna tayong action, no? So, there's an input name called search last name, and then there's an input button called search. Okay, what happens is that when the user, in every form, there's only one submit button, okay? And the search button is a submit button. So, what happens is that when that user clicks the submit button, the input name, search last name, is sent. Okay, as a parameter to the get request, which means you can now send it as a parameter to the next page. Before we do that, no, before we handle the search, let's run this first, no. So we can do a little ano. We can do a little I hope you don't have any error, no. We can do a little, which we'll log this out, no? Ah, pwede na yun si admin. Para wala tayong ano, no functionality, no? So, meron na itong registration, no? We'll go to employee management. Okay? So, ganito ang gusto kong gagawin. Okay? You have list, okay, list, and then search last name, and then when he clicks the, no, he will start searching. Okay? Any questions? Moralde is here. Then we'll start searching. Okay. Do you follow? So, yun lang yung gagawin natin ngayon. No? Pagtapos na, we have everything. Now, pangit sa, how do we move this to the right? We'll make it an MMD column. Okay. We'll create columns. No? Mas madali siya man. And then the list of employees here is quite large. So, gawin natin itong H4. Okay? We have a row, no? Ang gagawin natin is, we'll make this into column. So, we'll say, okay? Okay? We'll make this a div class call. Div class call. So, maging column siya. Then we now have a table with one row and two columns. Okay. The first column is the header list of employees. The second column is the form. Div plus all. So we have two columns, no? So this is a bootstrap, no? Bootstrap. Okay. May div dapat dito. Okay. Ayan. Wala pa tayong form action. We'll just run this anyway. So we have a row of two columns so that they will be on the same row. No? Okay. So nandito na. We have last name and search, no? Automatic ito, no? Now if you want to change the no, the no, you can add MD4, no? Call MD4, call and call MD4. So I think this is okay now, no? Do you follow? Okay, so ang gusto natin gagawin if kung mag-search siya ng De La Cruz and then click this, okay? It will only search for the last name De La Cruz. If it's empty, it will search everything. Any questions so far? No? So what we're going to do is to go to our controller, no? And we will create the show search result, no? Mag-create tayo ng action. Okay? Ito, no? This is called the show search employee results, okay? I'm going to explain this, no? So dito tayo sa controller. Sa employees controller, no? Let me create a function. It's an HTTP post. No? You follow dito sa dulo. It's a post because it's generated from the submit button. Okay? Basta generated from a submit button, it's always a post. Okay? You follow? Okay. What we are going to pass the string search last name. If you look at the index HTML, we have an input name search last name. They follow all this will be sent as parameter to the get request, no? For the post, no? Parameter to the post request when the submit button is clicked. The submit button on this form. Okay, if you're familiar with HTML, you should already know that when a submit button of the form is clicked, no, the input, the all the inputs involved in the form will be sent as parameter to the post. Okay, we follow it. In this case, we only have one input name with a placeholder last name. No, they follow. The name of this is search last name. That's the name of the input. Any questions so far? Okay, so let's go back to our employees controller. So, ganyan, no? So, it's an error because it doesn't have a return. Anyway, it will be gone. Okay? So, what we'll do first is check if the last name is null. Okay? If the last name is equal to null, what will we do if the last name is null? Okay? We will just return, okay, to the view index. You don't have to. We will pass the same, okay? We will return to the index view, okay? And pass the same context that employees. Sino yung si that context that employees? Ito yung sa taas, no? Kung DB context, the model involved, no? Ito, si application DB context. This is the model, no? Involved in this controller. So, si application DB context dot employees. So, it will, so, that particular model will be passed, no? As is. So, which means, just pass the same. This doesn't have to be a redirect because there's only one level. Do you follow? Okay? Else, this is the important part, no? Else, if it's not null, what will we do? We'll copy the same return, but we will add a where condition. Okay. Fortunately, we have a where conditions in ano. Do you follow? Let's add the where condition. We'll say employees dot where. Okay. It's just like an SQL statement. No? And we have a anonymous function. No? It's like in JavaScript. Ang ibig sabihin nitong ganito is we have a function which has a parameter e. We don't have to create the function, no? Which has a parameter e and it will return the following, no? Okay? E dot, okay? Last name, ayan, may last name na yan. Galing yan sa isang context eh, no? E dot last name dot contains. That contains, no? The search last name string. Okay, ito siya, yung gipas, no? The search last name string. Okay? And then we'll have to convert this to list, no? Because this will be passed on to the index, no? To list async. Okay? So ganun lang. So we'll pass a new set of employees, no? Actually, this is the from the model where there's a last name condition. Okay? They follow? Okay? So our show search employee results. This is our, no? I think this is just a warning. We copy this. Okay? We copy this so that in our controller, our form action, ASP action will be the same function. It will call that function. Okay? Let's rebuild this. May kulang na tayo. Kaya nagkaroon ng ganun. But because we don't have a semicolon here. Okay? It's obvious, no? Okay, any questions so far? No? So, one session lang tayo ngayon, okay? Let's go to admin and then go to employee management. Okay. Let's search for De La Cruz. No? If you click search, oh, may error, no? Subtype. Bakit may error tayo? May error ako sa aking code. Baliktarin ko nga ito. Okay. No. We should have an await. I'm sorry, no? Kailangan natin ng await. Okay. This one, if we should have an await. Why? Because the above is an async, no? Basta merong task like this, no? Okay? Can we also do an await here? Hindi na kailangan dito, no? Anyway, there are no changes. Kailangan natin ng await. Okay, let's run this again. Hope it works. There's no error. Then employee management. Let's do a search. So, De La Cruz na lang. Okay? For example, you will search Smith. Smith na lang. If you, with an empty search, it will show everything. Do you follow? So we have a complete CRUDS. Kompleto na yung CRUDS natin. Let's, this is the one, no? Ito, may error siya sa edit. May error siya sa edit. Kasi, our edit doesn't have redirect to action. Okay, let me run that again. Dapat pag-edit kasi, redirect to action, okay? No, it's not role management, it's employee management, okay? Dito siya nagkamali, no? Back to list. Okay na siya, no? Let's do that again. De La Cruz. Search. Edit. Okay na. We follow. Any questions so far? Okay. So, pag details. Okay. Any questions? So you have a complete CRUDs. This is what I'd like you to do in your project. Okay.
Sir, what if ano kana mag-search ka gano kalang what if na type po ka sa search ba unsay may tabo ana? Kunwari instead of De La Cruz kay mali ang na type ni
okay. Mali, sa De La Cruz. Let's try that anyway, no? Wala kalaman kay wala mo siya makita na DFDF.
Ah, okay. Okay, so dili siya mag-error ka ng one tawag ana.
Mag-kuan prompt.
Apo.
Actually, you can do a prompt. You would like to do that? Kasi pwede natin gagawin dito. I-check muna natin yung ano. Pagkatapos ng where. Okay? Dito pagkatapos ng where, i-check mo muna kung may laman ito. Okay? Do you follow? I'll construct the code. Mahirap kasi gagawin online kasi alam mo lang, masyadong ano yung syntax. So, what you can do is actually check if this is empty. If this is empty, you can just show an HTML that will say it's not found. Katulad nitong not found na to. Ito. So, ipatakboy mo dito sa not found. Do you follow? There's a way to do that. In fact, there are many examples, no? But at this point, I think it's logical na. Logical na siya, no? Na pag walang ma-search, it will return empty. Anyway, if it returns empty, you can do anything. Di ka maka-edit, di ka maka-delete. Do you follow? No? Any more questions? So, madaling, no? There are a few things that you have to, ano? Ang mahirap lang naman dito yung role management. But I'm going to upload the whole source code. They follow, so you have a bonus, no? Ito, meron na kayong bonus dito. Okay? They follow? Now, which is easier? Sa .NET or sa .NET Core? Depende, no? Okay? You have better control in ASP.NET. Ang problema dito, we don't do SQL anymore. We don't write stored procedures. Right? Diba? Unlike doon sa ASP.NET, you will have to write your own stored procedure so you know what's happening in SQL. Dito, you're convenient because even if you don't know SQL, you can develop a web page. You can develop a web application even if you don't know SQL. Sa ASP.NET, kailangan ka talagang marunong mag-SQL. Do you follow? Dito, hindi na tayo nag-SQL. Siya nabahala lahat. Okay? Any questions? Okay. I will upload all the source code, no? And then we'll still meet on Monday so I can also brief you present to you the source code, the whole source code. So you can use them to create your project. Now, in terms of ASP.NET, the whole source code is already there. Now, kung gusto niyo ASP.NET, you pick a choice. Which platform do you want to develop, no? ASP.NET or ASP.NET Core? Okay? It's up to you, no? Any questions so far? Any other questions? No? There are pros and cons, no? ASP.NET Core is easy. You can do it without SQL. Okay? It does the SQL for you. But there's a lot of functionality that we don't know. Kasi the code is generated for you. Unlike in ASP.NET, you really have to build the code yourself. Okay. So, wala namang problema pag wala siyang ma-search, okay? Kasi hindi ka naman maka-edit, maka-delete. Any questions so far? Okay. So, I think that ends our session for today. Our very last topic. Okay. Sir, is algorithm have similar ideas in old project? But yes. Halos pareha lang ito yung ating old project sa Windows. Okay? Kaya lang wala lang tayo ditong we don't have a master detail. Kasi mahirap talaga yung master detail i-implement sa web. In fact, the easier way is a shopping cart. No? Pero master details like invoices, no purchase orders, ang hirap niyang gagawin. You'd rather do that in Windows. Okay? Mas madali yung i-develop as Windows apps, not as web applications. Ang web applications, for example, are suited for search and search queries like, for example, in your SAS, di ba? You want to search for grades, no? But you do not do the encoding of the schedules there. Yung scheduling ng mga courses, hindi pwede doon. They do their encoding in Windows. There's a different application used to build the data. Or all you can do is just maybe a shopping cart, like when you do adding and dropping of subjects, no? That's the most you can do. Hindi mo pwedeng gawin lahat sa, ano, you can do everything in the web. It's limited. Now, in ASP.NET Core, mahirap gumawa ng reports. Okay? Unlike in ASP.NET, you can still use RDLC to print your reports to the printer. Okay? Any questions so far? No, talagang mahirap, no? That's a trade-off. Okay? So if you have no questions, we might as well. Can we end the session? No? Because I'm going to upload all the ano, all the codes in Daigler one by one. Ang dami na nito eh. Okay. Okay. See you next meeting. No? Next week will be our last week. Thank you very much, everyone. No? You can email me if you have concerns. No?